Is that you?
Yes, Mother.
So what have you been up to all day?
I've been taking pictures.
Have you really? That's marvelous. Where did you go to take pictures today?
Well, I went just down the road to the old field there around the corner.
It must be beautiful in the fall weather.
It is. It's beautiful out there.
Did you find any red leaves?
I did. Lots of red leaves.
I'm so glad you got to be out in the sunshine today. What do you have planned for tomorrow?
Oh, me too. You know, I don't really think I have anything planned tomorrow. Maybe I'll take some more pictures, but, you know, I don't really have much going on now that James is gone.
Why, Ruth Kenney, how are you, dear?
I'm well, Mrs. Finkler, thank you.
You know, I saw you last week at the Red Cross convention. I thought to myself how proud Ruth's father would be if he were still alive to witness all the work she's been doing, helping with this horrible war.
Thank you, Mrs. Fanbrick.
You know, if he were still alive, though, he would be in this fighting in this dreadful war, along with a million other men who are risking their lives every day, including, you know, my dear little Johnny. Yes, your father would be fighting if it wasn't for that typhoid fever that took him 5 years ago. Oh, what a dreadful war. What a dreadful war. Your father was fortunate that he survived the first one.
Oh, yes, he was.
Do you still use that old camera he gave you?
Yes, I do. Quite frequently, actually.
Oh, wonderful. That's wonderful. Your father enjoyed the camera and photography so very much. As I imagine you do, too.
I do. Well, thank you, Mrs. Fanbrick, but I must get these groceries home.
Oh, of course, dear, of course. Say hello to your mother and grandfather for me.
I will.
All right.
Hello, Tony.
Hello. Hello, Ruth. Can I help you with that?
Oh, no, thank you, Tony. I've got these just fine.
I heard James was drafted.
Yes, he was.
Well, it won't be long before I can enlist. My birthday is next month, and I'll be turning 18. And seeing how I'll be enlisting and I'll be leaving probably soon after, how would you like to go have a soda with me tomorrow afternoon?
I'm sorry to disappoint you again, but I just don't have time for outings, and I can't imagine getting a soda with anyone but James.
Ruthie.
Don't call me Ruthie.
Ruth, I really think we could be great friends. If you would just allow us to spend more time together. I mean, we have a lot in common.
I'm sorry, Tony, but we do not have a lot in common. So if you'll excuse me, I must hurry home.
Ruthie!
Do not call me Ruthie.
Mother, how was work?
It was good. I'm still pretty new at the job, but I think I'm getting the hang of it. And we're making it possible for our military to have the equipment that they need. I think your dad would be proud of me.
Yes, he would.
How was your day been?
Oh, it was fine. I ran into Mrs. Fanbrick on my way home from the store.
Oh.
She says hello. And I also ran into Tony.
That poor boy. Did he ask you on a date?
Yes, he did, as he often does every single time I see him.
Oh, how we can't wait for the day of our James's return.
Yes, indeed.
Thank you.
perception.
Isn't that neat?
Is it what neat? I don't see anything. James? James? I thought you left me.
I'd never leave. Thank you.